This video is sponsored by brilliant.org. This is a really big pendulum. And unlike the pendulum in a clock, this Foucault pendulum at the University of Puget Sound is free to swing in any direction. It takes about 8 seconds for it to go from there over to here and back. But that's not the motion that I want to show you. Now, this is not an interactive exhibit, but I have special permission. The motion I want to show you is too slow for you to see, so I'm going to speed things up in this video about 480 times so that you only see the pendulum when it's at this point in its swing here. And doing that will compress the next 32 hours into 4 minutes of video. We're going to try science. Played back at this speed, the pendulum appears to move around the room, but that doesn't really grasp what's really happening, because the ground is what's moving. It's rotating. You are watching the world turn. Let me explain. The pendulum ticks back and forth due to the law of inertia, which states that an object in motion stays in motion, unless something acts on it. So the pendulum continues to swing along this plane of motion, and from its point of view, it's just swinging back and forth along that same plane. From the pendulum's point of view, the ground is what's moving. Now, while that's incredible if you ask me, it can also be hard to grasp. So I want you to picture this. A Foucault pendulum placed at the North Pole would appear to complete a clockwise circle once every 24 hours, as the Earth completes a day by rotating beneath it. But that isn't always the case, because at the poles, the relative rotation between a pendulum and the Earth's axis is at its maximum. So the closer you move a pendulum towards the equator, the longer it takes for a so-called pendulum day to take place. That's the amount of time it takes for a Foucault pendulum to move around the room, as it were. Here at the University of Puget Sound, a pendulum day is about 32.3 hours long. Now, the reason it isn't 24 hours here is because the Earth is a sphere. So, the closer you put a pendulum to the equator, the further it is from the Earth's axis. And the greater the difference in angle between the Earth's axis and the plane that the pendulum is on. The greater that difference is, the less relative rotation there is between the pendulum and the Earth. So it takes at least 24 hours to see one pendulum day, and potentially much longer. You can actually figure out your latitude just by watching and timing a pendulum as it moves in this way, but of course, there's easier ways to do that. It's now 5:30 in the morning, but I'm awake and ready to get back at it. At the equator, a pendulum day lasts forever. And that's because at that location, a pendulum is perpendicular to the axis of rotation. The planet and the pendulum's plane are not moving in relation to one another. Here in the northern hemisphere, Foucault pendulums rotate clockwise because of the Earth's rotation. And that rotation also causes sundial shadows to move clockwise. I mean, it's probably where we got the term clockwise in the first place. If we put a pendulum at the South Pole, it goes counterclockwise, but again, it takes 24 hours. We talk about the sun rising and setting, but that only appears to happen because of Earth's rotation, and up until this experiment was done, we could only assume that the Earth was spinning due to our observations of the sun, of the moon, and of the stars, but no one had figured out how to do an experiment to actually test that until 1851, when a physicist named Léon Foucault came up with this, and that provided the very first simple proof that the Earth rotates. He did all of that using nothing but a pendulum, and if you ask me, that is pretty remarkable. And that is a pendulum day. Now, it's worth noting that most Foucault pendulums on display, like this one, have an electromagnet at the top. But that's just to keep them going forever. You could just use a normal pendulum to do this experiment and get the same results. It just wouldn't last as long. And maybe that's a good thing, because this took me a long time. Making this video took math, engineering, physics, and a lot of effort. And I put in that effort so that I might inspire you to learn more about this incredible world around us. And that is why I've teamed up with Brilliant.org to help make that possible. Brilliant focuses on problem-based learning, and I really like that because I know that studies show that solving problems is one of the most effective ways to learn things. It's also just fun. Every day they release several daily problems in math, science, computer science, and engineering. And from those you can go deeper into an interactive course. And there's a recent daily problem on Brilliant that I really like about the physics of how to water your plants while you're away. And it turns out that there's a much simpler solution to that than building a robotic cactus watering machine like I did. So whether you want to learn more about the physics of everyday life, get better at math in ways that's actually useful, or just want to expand your horizons, go to brilliant.org/Kurtis and finish your day a little smarter. The first 200 of you to do so will also get 20% off of the annual subscription and gain access to all the daily problems in their archives, as well as the problem-solving courses. Also, using that link will let them know that I sent you, which I would really appreciate, so please check it out. And as always, thanks so much for watching. Also, I want to give a thanks to the University of Puget Sound for letting me literally camp out beneath their pendulum. And for those of you that are new here, if you press subscribe, you will add a literal drop of water to one of these plants, and that's all that's keeping them alive.